Cacao versus leucine, the coffee secret to rebuild muscles after 60. If you could only choose one addition to your morning coffee to stop muscle loss after 60, would you pick leucine or cacao? In the next minutes, I'll show you exactly when each one works best, the precise doses that matter, and why the answer might surprise you. This isn't guesswork, this is what the research actually shows. As a wellness researcher who's spent the last 3 years analyzing studies on muscle preservation in older adults, I've discovered something fascinating. Most people think all supplements work the same way, but leucine and cacao target completely different pathways in your body. One rebuilds muscle directly, the other creates the conditions for muscle to thrive. And when you know which to use when, the results can be remarkable. Here's what will shock you about these two compounds. Leucine acts like a direct command to your muscles saying, build new tissue now, but only when you give it the right supporting cast. Cacao works like a master key, unlocking blood flow and reducing inflammation so everything in your body works better. And the timing of when you use each one can mean the difference between feeling stronger in weeks versus spinning your wheels for months. We have a few minutes together, and by the end, you'll know exactly which one to choose for your goals, and I'll give you a simple 7-day protocol that you can start tomorrow morning. But before we dive in, do something for me right now. Tell me in the comments what city and country you're watching from, and whether you've tried adding anything to your coffee for health benefits before. I'm going to settle this leucine versus cacao debate once and for all today. The mechanism behind each one is completely different, and that's exactly why one might be perfect for you while the other falls flat. The research on leucine in older adults surprised even the scientists studying it. And what I discovered about cacao's effect on mobility will change how you think about your morning routine. Let's start with leucine, and here's something that sounds almost too simple, but the science is rock solid. Leucine is like a molecular switch that turns on muscle building in your body. Within 30 minutes of having leucine with adequate protein, your muscles receive a direct signal to start building new tissue, and this works even when you're over 60. Here's exactly why this matters for you. After age 60, your muscles become resistant to the normal signals that tell them to grow and repair. It's like they've gotten harder of hearing. But leucine acts like someone shouting "wake up" directly into your muscle cells. The research shows that 2 to 3 grams of leucine with 25 to 30 grams of quality protein can restore the muscle building response to levels similar to someone decades younger. This is absolutely critical for activities like climbing stairs, getting up from chairs, and maintaining your balance. Your leg muscles need that direct rebuilding signal, and leucine provides exactly that when combined with adequate protein. Here's exactly what to do if muscle rebuilding is your priority. Add 2 to 3 grams of leucine powder to your morning coffee, along with 20 to 30 grams of whey protein, or have it with a protein-rich breakfast. The timing matters. Do this within an hour of waking when your body's protein synthesis machinery is most responsive. If you're managing diabetes, this actually helps with blood sugar control too. Dorothy, who's 74, started this leucine protocol after struggling to get up from low chairs. Within 6 weeks of combining leucine with her morning protein and short daily walks, she told me that standing up felt effortless again, something she hadn't experienced in years. This leucine approach directly commands muscle building, but what I'm about to share works through a completely different pathway, and it might be exactly what you need if energy and blood flow are your bigger concerns. We're a few minutes in, and you now understand the muscle building pathway. But here's where it gets interesting. Some people need the circulation and energy pathway more than direct muscle commands. Before continuing, I've put together a complete guide to coffee additions that actually work for seniors. You'll find the link in the first comment. Now let's talk about cacao and prepare to have your assumptions challenged. Most people think cacao is just about antioxidants, but the real magic happens in your blood vessels and how efficiently oxygen and nutrients reach your muscles and brain. Cacao contains compounds called flavanols that act like natural vasodilators, meaning they help your blood vessels relax and open up. Better blood flow means your muscles get more oxygen and nutrients, your brain works more clearly, and your energy stays steadier throughout the day. This is especially important as we age because blood vessel function naturally declines. Here's what the research shows that will amaze you. In clinical trials with adults over 65, those who consumed cacao rich in flavanols showed significant improvements in mobility, reduced inflammation markers, and better quality of life scores. This wasn't just feeling a little better. This was a measurable improvement in how well their bodies functioned. The key is getting real cacao, not processed cocoa. When cacao gets alkalized, which is common in commercial cocoa powders, it destroys most of the beneficial flavanols. You want raw, natural cacao powder that hasn't been Dutch processed? Here's your practical cacao protocol. Add 1 teaspoon of raw cacao powder to your morning coffee. You can enhance the flavor with cinnamon or vanilla, but avoid adding sugar, which counteracts the benefits. This gives you a therapeutic dose of flavanols that can improve blood flow within hours. James, who's 69, switched from regular cocoa to raw cacao in his coffee, and noticed within 2 weeks that his afternoon energy crashes disappeared and his morning mental clarity improved dramatically. He said it felt like someone had upgraded his circulation system. This cacao approach optimizes your body's delivery system, but now comes the big question. Which one should you choose, and is there a smart way to use both? Count on your fingers how many days per week you do some form of physical activity, even light walking. Comment that number below because it affects which approach will work better for you. We're at the halfway point, and here's where I'm going to give you the honest comparison that nobody else will. If your primary goal is rebuilding muscle mass, getting stronger legs, and improving your ability to climb stairs and get up from chairs, leucine wins. The research is clear that leucine with adequate protein directly stimulates muscle protein synthesis in a way that cacao simply cannot match. But if your primary concerns are energy levels, mental clarity, circulation, and overall vitality, cacao takes the lead. The improvements in blood flow and reduction in inflammation create the foundation for everything else to work better. Here's the strategy that makes the most sense for people over 60. You don't have to choose just one. On days when you're being more physically active, even if it's just a longer walk or some light exercises, prioritize leucine with protein. On days when you're focusing on mental tasks, reading, or need steady energy for daily activities, emphasize cacao. This alternating approach gives you the benefits of both pathways without overcomplicating your routine. Your muscles get the direct building signals when they're being challenged, and your circulation system gets optimized for overall function and energy. Now I'm going to give you a simple 7-day protocol that takes the guesswork out of this completely. Try this awareness exercise with me right now. Think about yesterday morning. Did you feel more like you needed physical strength or mental energy and steady circulation? This helps you understand your body's daily patterns. A few more minutes to go, and I'm about to give you the exact weekly protocol that combines the best of both approaches. Here's your simple 7-day leucine and cacao protocol that takes all the guesswork out of when to use what. Days 1, 3, and 5, these are your cacao days. Add 1 teaspoon of raw cacao powder to your morning coffee, and plan for 10 to 15 minutes of light walking or gentle movement. The cacao optimizes your circulation for the activity, and the movement helps distribute the improved blood flow throughout your body. Days 2, 4, and 6, these are your leucine days. Add 2 to 3 grams of leucine powder along with 20 to 30 grams of whey protein to your coffee, or have it with a protein-rich breakfast. Follow this with some strength-focused activity, even if it's just standing up and sitting down in a chair 10 times. The leucine provides the muscle-building signal, and the movement tells your body where to direct that building. Day 7 is your evaluation day. Reflect on which days you felt stronger physically and which days your energy and mental clarity were better. This helps you understand your body's response and adjust the protocol for the following week. The beauty of this system is that it works with your body's natural rhythms instead of against them. You're providing muscle-building support when you're being active and circulation support when you need steady energy and mental function. Margaret, who's 76, followed this exact protocol for 1 month. She told me that by week 3, she could clearly feel the difference between her leucine days and cacao days. The leucine days made her legs feel more solid and strong, while the cacao days gave her sustained energy that lasted well into the evening. This protocol gives you the benefits of both compounds, while keeping everything simple and sustainable. But there are a few important safety considerations and honest limitations you need to know about. Look in your kitchen right now. Do you have any cocoa powder or protein powder? Comment what you have, because I want to make sure you're using the right types for maximum benefit. We're almost done, and I want to be completely honest about what works and what doesn't with these two approaches. Here's the important safety and effectiveness information that other content creators won't tell you. Leucine works best when you have adequate total protein in your diet. If you're not eating enough protein overall, leucine alone won't create the muscle-building effect you're looking for. Think of leucine as the ignition key, but you still need fuel in the tank. Cacao can contain small amounts of caffeine and theobromine, which are stimulants. If you're sensitive to caffeine, start with half a teaspoon to see how you respond. And remember, not all cacao is created equal. Avoid sweetened cocoa powders or coffee creamers with cocoa, as the added sugars can counteract the benefits you're trying to achieve. Most importantly, neither leucine nor cacao is a replacement for staying physically active in whatever way works for your body. They enhance and support the benefits of movement, but they can't replace the fundamental importance of using your muscles regularly. The research shows that when leucine and cacao are used as part of an overall healthy lifestyle that includes appropriate physical activity, the benefits can be significant. But used alone without any movement or attention to overall nutrition, the effects will be limited. Robert, who's 71, learned this the hard way. He started with leucine but wasn't eating enough protein overall and saw minimal results. When he increased his daily protein intake and added the leucine, the difference was remarkable within just a few weeks. These compounds are powerful tools, but they work best as part of a comprehensive approach to healthy aging that includes movement, adequate nutrition, and consistency over time. In a few minutes, you've learned exactly how leucine and cacao work differently in your body, when to use each one, and a practical protocol for getting the benefits of both. You don't have to choose between muscle building and circulation support. You can have both when you understand the right timing and approach. The key insight is that your body has different needs on different days, and having both tools available lets you respond to what you need most. Some days, your muscles need that direct building signal from leucine. Other days, your circulation and energy systems need the support that cacao provides. Remember, consistency beats perfection every time. Start with whichever approach sounds more appealing to you right now, try it for a week, and pay attention to how your body responds. You can always add the other approach once the first one becomes routine. Which approach sounds more interesting to you right now? The muscle-building pathway with leucine or the circulation and energy pathway with cacao? Tell me in the comments, because I read every single one and often reply with specific suggestions based on your individual situation. If this helped you understand a science-based approach to supporting your strength and energy after 60, consider subscribing for more evidence-based content that actually works for people in our age group. Your body deserves information that's both effective and honest about what really makes a difference. The information I've shared today is for educational purposes and should be discussed with your healthcare provider, especially if you take medications or have health conditions. But when used appropriately, these natural compounds can be valuable additions to a comprehensive approach to healthy aging. Your journey to feeling stronger and more energetic starts with your next cup of coffee. And now you know exactly how to make that coffee work harder for you. If you want more tips, grab our ebook and turn your morning coffee into a fountain of youth with 5 simple ingredients that fight muscle loss, joint pain, and fatigue after 60.